morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Friday. I got the day wrong once this week, which is the first time in now over 2 years of doing these daily videos, inviting you behind the scenes here at my studio. And wow, that one tells you what a busy week it has been, but also really reminds me we have been together for a long time. Some of you have really been a part of the behind the scenes community since the beginning. And whether you have been here from day one or this is your first day joining me, I'm so glad you're here and that we've connected. And one of the other ways I'm hoping we will all be connecting is through the Give a Girl a Journal initiative, which launches on Sunday. I know that has been the topic every day here in the studio this week, but this is one of the biggest projects I have ever launched, and I am so excited about this plan to get as many journals into the hands of as many girls as possible and empower them to use them. One of the things I think about a lot is how when we create something, we work so hard. Maybe this is my background in theater too. We work so hard that when somebody is sitting down in the audience, that their whole experience from the time they buy a ticket to the time they walk in to the time they sit down and they watch the show, that it all feels smooth and effortless, like a magical creation that awoke for their enjoyment. And behind the scenes, people are working so incredibly hard and have dedicated so much time and energy. It's like, you know, have you heard that image of the duck that way, that the duck is gliding along the top of the water, but under, going like this. And one of the reasons I started doing these behind the scenes at all was to try to give a little bit of a picture of what those feet are doing underneath. A lot of reasons why I think that's important. One is so that when we do step into something that is important to us and big and expansive and grows us, and we suddenly bump up against something that's hard. Like yesterday, I was working on using a new shopping cart, and it involved using liquid code, which I didn't even know what that was. And I had to dive into the pieces and look at the code and figure things out. And it was hard. Now, that didn't mean that Give a Girl a Journal isn't a great project because there was a piece of it that was hard. It didn't even mean that using this particular surface was necessarily bad because a part of it was hard. The road takes effort. And I share that so that we don't confuse that kind of stopped energy that's like, no, not here, this isn't for you, with that energy of, okay, there is like an obstacle here. I've got to figure it out. I got to get over, under, or through. I have to learn something. I have to stretch somehow. I have to grow in some new way. I have to ask for help. That is the way that our projects can grow us to a new level of possibility. I had a directing teacher when I was in graduate school, and he really encouraged us when we went out to see some theater to really recognize that even when something is awful, it's boring, it doesn't make sense, some things didn't happen on time, whatever it is that makes it just not a good show, to acknowledge just how much love and care and work went into it. That no matter how much didn't work, behind it was hours and hours and hours of commitment and creation. Those people certainly did not intend to put on a show that you didn't enjoy. They were trying with all their might to make it work. So often we watch something from afar and we think, oh, she should have done this. Oh, that would have been better if he'd done that. And we may be right. That may be a great addition to whatever it is that's being created. But also really know the hundreds and hundreds of decisions that have been made, of hours that have been spent, of conversations that have gone on, of sleepless nights noodling, of journal hours. All of that has been put into the e-course, the podcast, the video series. Hope that we can all take a moment when we see somebody launch something, create something, share something, to really acknowledge the bravery in it, the work of it, the commitment to it, the energy that it took to bring something to life and put it out there in the world, and to really celebrate that. It's such a joy when we all share our gifts, when we all bring to life what it is, that seed that's inside our heart, and share it with the world. One of the things that I love so deeply about creating, about living a creative life, is that it takes us on a heroic journey, that it takes us through the full gamut of human experience. It reveals our foibles and our brilliance, that it asks something of us and it gives us even more. And I think it invites us to be ourselves in a deep and shining way, and to show up bravely. And this year, I am just so excited to, after many years of thinking about it, be showing up for Give a Girl a Journal, and to see the way it is inviting other people to show up too, the way immediately a band of journaling sisters is coming together saying, yes, this is a practice that means something to me. Here is how I do it. Here is why I do it. We all have different journal stories, and it means so much to me that we're sharing them. I will be sharing some from my friends and colleagues over the next several days at Jamie Riddler Studios at openthedoor.ca, and I'm inviting you to share your journal story, to create something and offer it up to the world, to say, here's what journaling means to me. You can do it in a video, you can do it in a blog post, you can do it on Instagram. Just use the hashtag GiveAGirlAJournal. To support the project, link back to GiveAGirlAJournal.com. We are going to share for the blog hop and social media extravaganza on Sunday. I really hope you will be a part of this. I'm going to have a wonderful time in your studio. Remember, your life is your studio. I hope one of the things you'll be creating is your journal story to share on Sunday as a part of Give a Girl a Journal. Thanks so much for being here this week, for being a part of the excitement and adventure and story of Give a Girl a Journal coming to life. I appreciate you. I will talk to you on Monday, and hopefully see you at the blog hop on Sunday.